couple more breaths.
Adam.
Yeah.
All-Star Classic.
Yep.
He beat you.
Yep.
I know it don't count, and it's an exhibition. It counts.
Yeah.
It counts.
It definitely counts in the heart and in the practice room for sure.
And in seating. Yeah. They say it doesn't count. It does.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, that too. But, yeah, I mean, it was just kind of cool that, you know, started my season with him, and then I ended with him on the mat, and it's just great to kind of get that one back. He's been beating me for a few years now, so it's just great to finally get one back where it counts.
This is an all-time great weight class.
Yeah.
This is going to go down in NCAA history as an all-time great weight class. You're third in the weight.
Yeah.
You got a world champ in the finalist for, you know, a potential all-time great, you know,
yep.
going for his third title.
Yep.
You take third. Desi's a world champ. He takes fifth. You pin him.
Yeah.
What's this do now with the whole landscape now? It's all shaken out. What's this mean, third place?
It means that I wrestled hard. That's what it means. You know, I took a loss there to Gwiz. It was a really tough match. You know, things didn't quite go my way, and I fought, and I'm happy the way that I fought. Not quite happy with the result, but it was just a hard, you know, dogfight throughout the, you know, these past 3 days. So I'm real happy with how I performed in every single match, because I was going out there and getting it, and it's just, again, one more stepping stone to eliteness.
He had mentioned Desi was a junior world champ. You were second to him that year.
Right? Third, actually. I faced him in the semis.
Semis, okay. But the fact is, when you pinned him here, it looked like it meant even more to you. Does it go back to moments like that?
For sure. For sure. It's one of those, as soon as I, you know, got him on his back, you know, I had flashbacks of him getting that takedown with 13 seconds left. And it was one of those kind of, I'm going to squeeze that much harder to make sure I get this fall. Just because, you know, you get little flashbacks when you wrestle guys. You try to block those out as much as possible, but when it comes to that, it's nice to get those flashbacks, because then, even though you're tired from the past 2 days, you find that little extra energy to make sure you get that fall.
I look at you, and it's just like, I have a 1-month-old son, and I want him to be around people like you. You're like,
thank you.
Just like the role model of role models. You know, just a good guy, nice guy, future astronaut maybe, but you know, being a role model even for the Michigan team, fighting back, taking third, and being a nice guy like you are, how important is that?
You know, people may not always remember you know, how you did, how, you know, your accolades and all that stuff, but people will always remember how you are as a person. So that's the, you know, that's the kind of attitude I take when I talk to everybody, and you know, I always show them respect. You know, there's no fear, and you know, no fear of opponents and stuff, but there's always respect on the mat. And just, you know, in general as a person. So I always try to take that attitude. I had, you know, great parents raising me to make sure that I'm, you know, a humble person, and I try to, you know, present that as much as I possibly can. That,
Adam,
you know,
Adam,
be a good person.
Sorry, you'll be working upper body for the next 3 weeks, correct?
Yes.
Prepare for Iowa City. Talk about that challenge.
It's going to be great. Just going to have a couple guys coming in the room, make sure we're really working on gut wrenches. And then I got a couple of, you know, a couple throwing partners that are, you know, getting ready to get thrown right now. They're probably back, you know, stretching out, making sure that they're ready to get some tosses in. So,
but how much Greco have you done since December?
None. I haven't had any time of just strictly Greco. It's always been folk style. I might get a couple tosses here, but they're more folk style tosses than Greco tosses.
Why did you decide to do Greco for that? I have never had a chance to ask you that.
Yeah. It was something I wanted to do. Being an Olympic year, I wanted to at least try freestyle or Greco. And I figured, you know what, after a great training camp that I had at Greco over the summer, that was where I wanted to take, and I wanted to go Greco for this.
He had mentioned how great the college heavyweights are, but the senior level heavyweights in this country is probably maybe been the best ever. Your thoughts on that?
They're absolutely phenomenal. So I'm just going out there, and I'm gonna leave it all on the line, just like I did this past weekend. Just leave it all on the line and, you know, see where it takes me.
What's the biggest obstacle in Iowa City for you? Who would you say, what individuals? And have you guys qualified the weight yet for Rio?
The weight was qualified.
The weight's qualified, so it's an Olympic spot.
Yes.
Because, you know, if the weight's not qualified, you can win the Olympic trials, it doesn't matter.
You don't go
to wrestle in the Olympics. Okay, so who's the biggest obstacle in Iowa City?
Well, obviously Smith. He's going to, you know, he's the number one guy. He's returning. He's the one that qualified the weight in general. So
he's definitely fifth in the world.
Yep, fifth. So that was enough to qualify the weight. So obviously he's, you know, the number one spot. There's a couple other guys that I got to make sure I'm willing to go, you know, at all times.
He's a 211 pounder. He's an old 96 kilo guy that went up.
Yeah, but he's a big boy
now. He's a junkyard dog. He scraps. He lays it all out there. He's a kitchen sink guy.
Yeah.
What do you got to do to compete with a guy like that?
You got to go toe to toe with him. He's very, you know, very ferocious. Loves to throw. You know, fan favorite for sure. You know, he's got that big beard.
It's a junkyard dog, man.
Exactly. So the only way you can beat a guy like that is you got to go toe to toe and roll with the punches at that point. It might get bloody, but you know, I'm going to put everything I can out there. If he texts me or if I beat him, it doesn't matter. I'm going to put everything I can out there.
And it'll be a 2 out of 3 situation anyway.
If we get to, if we both meet in the finals. Seeding works out and we end up seeing the semis, then it's only one match.
Yeah, and if he would have medaled, he would have got a pass to the finals, wouldn't he?
I think he had to win it. I'm not positive.
Because Snyder and Burroughs are waiting.
Yeah, they're waiting because they won it. I think it was just win.
Okay, all right. Yep. Well, hey, man, always great to talk to you. Congratulations. Way to battle back after a disappointing semifinal loss.
Yeah, thank you.